Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jumper.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today a note from Morne. Morne stationed in Afghanistan and sent in an awesome, awesome tip. Morne's going to get an Excel master pin for this one. Talking about data validation. Data validation usually has to rely on a list that's on the same worksheet. I've talked in the past about how you can make that list be on another worksheet if you apply a name. I've also talked in the past about how that list can grow if you use the offset function. But Morne says, hey, there's an easier way, and he's absolutely right. Check it out. So we have our list here. I'm going to select the list, and in Excel 2007, I'm going to press CONTROL+T. In Excel 2003, you would have done CONTROL+L, and so it defines the data for the table. We click OK, and now I'm going to name that range. So I'll call it regions. All right, good enough. Now we come back here to sheet 1, and we go to data validation, and say that we're going to allow a list, and say the list is equal regions. Click OK. All right, so there's our drop-down with the items. Now, here's the really cool thing, and this is Morne's trick. If we come back here to the data sheet and type a brand new region, the Canada region, it automatically extends the list. It automatically extends the name that referred to the list, and it will appear at the bottom of the drop-down. Isn't that beautiful? Morne, thanks for sending that tip in. A great way to set up a dynamic range without having to try to figure out how to use the offset function. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.